Simulan na natin. So, for this discussion, discuss natin yung part 3 saka part 4 ng statics problems. So first, we have a segmented cable problem. For the cable shown daw, the maximum tension is 5 kilonewtons. Solve the support reactions AX, AY, DX, and DY. Naka-component lahat. And then also determine the tension force in each cable. So, tatlong tension forces, AB, BC, saka CD. And then determine the distance, YB, and YC din daw. And also the total length of the cable. Yan. So for this problem, binigay yung maximum tension. So we have to first determine saan siya mag-occur. Kung dito ba siya sa point A or sa point D. Now just by looking at the forces applied, yung 2.5 kN is larger than 1 kN. So essentially, mas malaki yung tension sa A. So dyan mag-occur yung maximum tension. But kung gusto mo talaga ng checking, you can compare DY saka AY, and then kung ano yung mas malaki, dyan mag-occur yung maximum tension. So, for this problem, we have a reaction at A, always tensile din yan, acting away from the body. So, we have AY saka AX. And then dito rin, merong DX saka DY. Yan. So, masosolve natin si AY saka DY by taking moments about D and A. So, summation of moments tayo about A. We have this load, 2.5 kN multiplied by 3.6. And then, plus 1 kN multiplied by dalawang 3.6. And then, minus dy, eto, multiplied by 3 plus dalawang 3.6. Yan, so set natin to 0. Yung makukuha natin na value ng dy is 1.588 kN. Yan. And then to solve AY naman, we can sum up forces na lang. Or you can also take moments about D, but mas efficient to. So we have AY minus natin yung 2.5 saka 1. And then plus DY. Set natin to 0. Now DY is 1.588. So, AY will be 2.5 plus 1 minus natin si DY. Yan. So, 1.912. Yan. Now, since AY is greater than DY, yung maximum tension pala is at A. So, max tension is at A. Yan. And so if the maximum tension is at A, itong 5 kN pala, yan, yung capacity ng cable, it acts dito. So this is 5 kN daw. So if this is 5 kN, yung reaction kasi sa support, yung total reaction niya, yan din yung tension force ng AB. Yung reaction force, total reaction or resultant reaction ng DY saka DX, yan din yung force sa CD. Yan yung concept ng cables natin. The same lang sa parabolic cables. So, now, alam na natin na the maximum tension is at A. So, di ba? Alam din natin yung value ng AY. So, we can, parang, isolve natin yung resultant and then unknown natin is AX. So, 5 yung maximum tension. Equal yan, di ba, sa AX squared plus AY squared. Yan. But, alam natin yung AY. AY is 1.912. Yan. So, equate natin. 5 equals square root of x squared plus 1.912 squared. Yan. Magiging 4.62. Yan. Now, since sa system natin, yung dalawang forces lang na nag-act horizontally are AX and DX, therefore, equal lang silang dalawa. So, AX equals DX equals 4.62 kN. Yan. And so, madali lang yung tension ng CD. Kasi yung tension ng CD, yan yung resultant ng dy saka dx. Yan. So, therefore pala, tension AB is, alam na natin yung maximum tension, so 5. Therefore, this is 5kN. Yan. Automatic na yan. And then, yung tension naman sa CD is square root of dx squared plus dy squared, which is dx natin 4.62. Yan. And then dy naman natin is ano nga yun? 1.588. Yan. So input natin, we have 4.89. And this is KN. Yan. So, yung tension sa BC, madali na lang kasi alam na natin yung tension force ng AB. So, diba, itong mga points mo, you can treat them as joints and then just sum up forces horizontal saka vertical. So, at joint B, yan, we have the following forces. This is 5kN. Alam na kasi natin yan. Yan yung tension ng AB. And then, we have an applied force of 2.5kN. Yan. And then, ito naman yung force sa BC. So, hindi pa natin alam yung inclination. So, we first have to solve the distances. Kung ano yung YB saka yung YC. Now, yung pinakamadaling way is to take moments about B to get YB and take moments about C to compute YC. And then, yung gagamitin natin na forces are the reactions. Kasi pwede kasi natin yung i-cut. Parang pa ganyan. And then, mag-moment tayo sa B to eliminate this force. So, taking moments about B pala. Equal to 0. Yan. We have AY natin is 1.912 multiplied by 3.6 going to point B. Yan. And then minus kasi it will cause, plus pala, sorry. plus kasi it will cause a clockwise rotation. Yung AX pala yung minus. So, minus AX multiplied by YB. Again, yung AX is 4.62. YB naman is unknown. Yan. So, solve natin si YB. We have 1.912 times 3.6 minus 4.62x equals 0. So this is 1.49. Hindi kn. Meters yan kasi distance. So, yan. 1.49. And then to solve YC, still the same cut, and then sa C tayo magmo-moment. So taking moments about C, yan, we have dy. Dy is 1.588. yan, and then this will cause a counterclockwise reaction, rotation about point C, so minus multiplied by 3. Yung distance niya yan. And then dx naman will cause a clockwise rotation, and then multiply natin by yc. Yan. And then again, dx is 4.62 din. So set to 0, we have minus yan, 1.588, this is 3, and then this is plus naman. So YC pala is 1.031. yan. So alam na natin si YB saka YC, so we will now be able to determine kung ano yung inclination dito. Yan. So, diba, ito, it has a horizontal distance of 3.6. And then, it has a height of YB. So, YB is 1.49. So, masosolve natin si theta. Yan. Which is the inclination with the horizontal. So, sabihin natin, theta A yan. Theta A. Ito naman, theta B. Yan. So, for BC naman, horizontal distance is 3.6. Yan. And then, the height is YB, babawasan natin ng YC kasi ito kasi yung triangle natin. Yan. So, diba, this is YB minus YC. Yan. So, sulat ko na lang. Yan. So, YB minus YC is 1.49 minus 1.031. So this is 0.459. Yan. So theta A is arctangent of opposite over adjacent. So opposite to theta is 1.49, adjacent naman yung 3.6. Yan. And then theta B naman is arctangent of opposite over adjacent pa rin, so 0.459 divided by ano yan, still 3.6. Yan. So, gagawin ko is to store ko na lang to sa variable A. Ito naman sa variable B. Yan, so shift tan 1.49 over 3.6. Yan, so 22.484. So shift store A, and then arctan of 0.459 over 3.6. This is 7.266. So shift store B. Yan. So at this joint, I can sum up forces along Y na lang. Or pwede rin na along X, depende na sa'yo. Wait, mas madali yata if yung ano na lang. Summation of forces along X na lang. So, wait lang. Summation of forces along X. By the way, dito pala, hindi na natin kailangan yung theta A. Kasi alam natin yung X component ng 5kN, yan din yung value ng AX. Or you can also use this one, pero medyo mahaba na yung solution. So, gagawin ko, 4.62 na lang. Yan, yung force niyan, opposite yung direction sila, ito toward the left, ito ito naman toward the right. So, equate na lang natin, BC cosine theta B. Yan. So, masasolve na natin yung BC. So, 4.62, divide natin by cosine B. Yan, we have 4.66. Yan. So, ito na yung last. Meron pa palang length ng cable. So, TBC is 4.66. Yan. Now, for the total length of the cable, gagamitin natin yung distances natin, horizontal and vertical distances, para kunin yung hypotenuse ng each line. Yan, kasi this is the hypotenuse of this triangle. Ito naman, hypotenuse ng triangle na to. And then, this one is the hypotenuse of this triangle. Yan. So, yung total length pala natin is square root ng we have to separate it pala. So first, let's look at this triangle. So 3.6 squared plus YB. So YB is 1.031 squared. And then plus ito naman, this triangle. Again, don't use YB kasi ito lang yung height ng triangle. So, YB minus YC was again 0.459. So, 0.459 squared plus horizontal distance is 3.6. And then plus ulit, square root of this triangle naman. So, it has a height of YC, which is 1.031 squared natin, and then plus 3 squared. Yan. So, input natin lahat. Sorry. Yung YB pala is 1.49 pala for this triangle. So, change lang natin. Yan. So, 3.6 squared plus 1.49 squared plus square root of 0.459 squared plus 3.6 squared and then plus square root of 1.031 squared plus 3 squared. So 10.697. Yan. Naka-meters yan. So, review natin. 1.49, 1.031, 10.697. So, tama lang yung mga sagot natin. And then, 5, 4.66, saka 4.89 for the tensile forces.